This is a short joint mobility exercise to help loosen up all your joints and also improve your range of motion. It's great to do before you're doing a workout or any form of exercise, or you can use it as a standalone routine to do on your off days, like I said, to just keep everything nice and loose. So, we're going to start off at your neck, and all I want you to do is stand up nice and tall, drop your ear down to your shoulder, then round to the other side. Keep your neck nice and long. You want to do roughly about 10 each side. Once you've done 10 each side, keep your mouth closed, look up to the ceiling, and take your chin down to your chest. Again, roughly about 10 in each direction, and the last one for your neck is looking over your shoulder, and then round to the other side. Try to get as much, as big a range of motion as you can with all of these exercises, but never go into pain. So if something hurts, just miss it out and don't do it. The next one we're going to do is for the shoulders. Now I'm going to turn my back to you slightly so you can see. One hand is coming over the top, the other hand is coming over the bottom, and you're going to try and touch your fingertips together. So you're swapping hands each time, one hand over the top, one hand coming over the bottom. Try and touch your fingertips together as best as get as close as you can. Again, you want to do roughly 10 each side. Next we're going to do is arm circles, keeping your arms straight and make as big a movement as possible. Again, we do 10 going backwards, then change the direction, 10 coming forwards. Once you've done that, hold your hands up at shoulder height, swing your arms behind you, and then swing them across your chest. If you get any clicking and cracking as you do these, as long as it's not painful, don't worry about it. It's generally just pockets of air that get trapped in your joints, and then as you move, you can just hear it pop out. So that's neck, shoulders, moving down to your waist. Next, the first one we're going to do, try to keep your hips facing forward. So squeeze your bum, squeeze your stomach a bit, twist, and then round to the other side. And then as you get loosened up, you can start adding a little bit of momentum. 10 each side again with those. Next one, hands on your hips, and we're doing hip circles. So making big circular motions with your hips. And you'll notice that my head is staying pretty central, and it's my hips that are doing most of the work. I'm not just spinning my head around like this, which you can turn, change direction. Yeah, moving down into your hamstrings, keeping your legs straight. I want you to keep your hands on your thighs and then reach down towards your toes, stand yourself back up. If you don't like your head going up and down, if it makes you feel dizzy, just keep looking forwards and just go down as low as you can so you feel a stretch on the back of your thighs. And then stand yourself back up. Again, 10 of these. Moving down to your knees. Bend your knees slightly, hands on your knees, and then you're just trying to make circular motions. Keep your feet flat on the floor. Do 10 in one direction, 10 in the other direction. Then for your ankles, if you need to use the wall for balance, you can. Put your toe in the floor behind you. And then you're just rolling your ankle round again, trying to make a circle if you can. It doesn't always feel like a circle to begin with, but the more you do it, the more fluid it'll become. And then change direction. And then exactly the same on the other leg. 10 in one direction, 10 in the other direction. So, yeah, doing this twice a day is going to help not only loosen your joints, but also improve the range of motion you get at each joint.